Okay, I'm just going to do a bit of an instructional video on setting up the spark gaps for Tesla coils. As you can see here, that's the oil burner transformer that I use. It's 11 kV, 18 milliamps, and on here I've mounted up the safety spark gap. You notice that there's a contact in the middle, which is earth for the case, and a contact on either side going to the terminals. Reason for this is if you just had the one spark gap and anything happened between a terminal and earth, you wouldn't protect it, so you need that center connection. If I turn it on, nothing appears to happen, but there's obviously some power there. What I do is set them up roughly going in, and you can use an insulator screwdriver on these ones because they've got screws. You go back about half a turn, turn it off and back on again, it's not arcing. So that's probably about the position that you want to be. I'll just set the other side up. Half turn, turn it off, back on again. Now they're not arcing at the moment, but when you bridge them, they do arc for a while and eventually they die. So that's more or less set up. That one isn't dying yet, but it will do eventually. So that's about right. When you turn it on and back off again, it's not arcing, but you can sustain an arc across the gap. You might want to go out say another half a turn if you find it's triggering a bit too erratically. The only reason I would use a safety gap is if I'm using a rotary, or if there's a problem with the connections, and there might be a danger to the transformer. But if I'm using a static spark gap, which is, as you'll see later on in the video, it'll be across the terminals and it'll be enough to protect the transformer. Okay, now on to the next stage. This is the main spark gap, two leads from the transformer, and a similar situation with two bolts with a gap between. If I trigger that, it may or may not spark. You might be able to hear just a faint buzz. It's not sparking at the moment. So that is set too far apart. Obviously, don't forget to turn off each time you do an adjustment. I just wound that in probably about half a turn each. And it's now arcing. And you can go out a little bit, try it again. No spark on that one. Just keep going in. That one sort of took a bit of time to start. So what you want to do is get a spark that starts reliably every time. Okay, that's the next bit. Now you notice that it's only the leads from the transformer that's connected to this, so it's offload. There's nothing else connected to it at all. And that's the way you should set up your main spark gap. After that, you want to lock it up and leave it. If you start playing with that while you're trying to tune your coil, then you're going to have some problems. Now, what I've done, I've actually mounted this on a piece of perspex, and I mounted banks of capacitors on perspex, so I can swap in and out. They're actually separate banks that are bolted together, so I can play as much as I want or as little as I want. Just zoom out so you can see a bit easier. This is the base of the glass jar coil that I was having a bit of trouble with. It's sort of working, still needs a bit of tuning, a bit of playing with. I think it actually needs a bigger transformer because I've only got 18 milliamps on this one. And that's the one going to capacitors. The bank is in series with the coil, the primary coil of the Tesla. And this is the other point of the primary coil. Got fairly strong fingers, so I'll just finger tighten them for now. It's good enough for the demonstration. Tight enough. Okay, what you'll notice now is that I've got the capacitors in series with the system onto the coil and back, and because of this capacitance and inductance and everything else, that spark will get a lot louder and more fierce. So there you are, that's the basics. The rest is all down to tuning, getting your coil, your primary coil tuned correctly, top loads and everything else. But that's covered in most other videos that I've seen on the net, if you're looking for Tesla coil tuning. But I've never seen anything really that went into enough detail on setting up your spark gaps. Hope this is found this quite helpful. And good luck with your Tesla coils.